Students, I am Dr. Mahoni Kalita, Department of Philosophy, Dispur College. Today I am going to discuss a very important topic, that is nature of inductive enquiry. This topic covers the syllabus of higher secondary second year. This is the first unit of the logic part of higher secondary second year. In higher secondary, we have logic and philosophy. In the logic part, this is the first topic. And in the second part, we got philosophy. This is the nature of inductive inquiry. Before discussing this topic, we should discuss about what is logic. The word logic comes from the word logiki. This is the Greek adjective. This logiki again comes from Greek noun, that is logos. It means thought expressed in language. Therefore, etymologically, logic means the science of thought expressed in language. Logic can be defined as the science of reasoning. It can be defined as the science of argument. It can be defined as the science of inference. There are two types of inference. One is deductive inference, another is inductive inference. In deductive inference, we proceed from universal to particular. That is from more general to less general. For example, all men are mortal. Ram is a man, therefore Ram is mortal. This is an example of deductive inference. But in inductive inference, we proceed from particular to universal, that is from less general to more general propositions. For example, Ram is mortal, Jodu is mortal, Hori is mortal, therefore all men are mortal. In inductive inference, from particular knowledge, we get universal knowledge. For example, the mortality of Ram, the mortality of Jodu, and the mortality of Hori gives us some particular knowledge. And from this particular knowledge, we get the universal knowledge, that is all men are mortal. The conclusion of deduction gives us no new information. The conclusion is implicit in the premises in deductive inference. Therefore, in deductive some new information, it is not implicit in the only in the premises. In induction, the conclusion is always probable. On the other hand, deduction is a descending process of reasoning. It is the downward movement. Because in deduction, we proceed from universal to particular, that is from more general proposition to less general proposition. But induction is an ascending process. It is an upward movement. In induction, we proceed from particular to general proposition. Deduction deals with formal truth, but induction deals with both material truth and formal truth. As material truth, induction relies on observation and experiment, and as formal truth, induction relies on the principle of the uniformity of nature and the law of position. Besides, in induction, we get inductive leap. Inductive leap is the most important characteristics of induction. It is a leap from known to the unknown. So this is all about induction. Today we know about the relation between the induction and deduction. And in the next class, we'll discuss about the kinds of induction. Thank you.